Hello and welcome to Simplified on Pardrift, a segment where we take complicated ideas and break them down into something simple so we can use it and we can understand it. If you haven't, this would be a good time to subscribe to Pardrift and hit the bell notification icon so that India's best automotive content finds you every single time. And today we're going to talk about brake fluids. The reason why we're talking about brake fluids is for two reasons. One, brake fluid degrades faster than you think, and that's why your brakes don't feel great after a while. And second, there is an easy upgrade and a cheap upgrade to be had in terms of what your brakes are able to do for you if you were to just pay attention. Now, on most vehicles today which have disc brakes, you have a hydraulic circuit. Then that means the master cylinder generates the pressure. It transmits this pressure through a tube down to the calipers where the pistons press against the brake pads. The brake pads then in turn press against the disc, and the friction loses kinetic energy, creates heat, and that's how your vehicle slows down. Now, most vehicles as standard get DOT-4 brake fluid, and I'm not going to go into the chemical composition of the brake fluid because that's not really important. What is important is what it does. Now, brake fluids have two properties that we need to pay attention to. The first is DOT-4 brake fluids, for example, love water. And as they're exposed to water, for example, by a leak in the tubing somewhere where it's able to take on even atmospheric water, like water vapor, the ability of this brake fluid to do its job starts to go away. The other property that we need to be aware of is that it has a boiling point. And once the brake fluid reaches boiling point and the fluid inside starts to boil, its ability to maintain reliable, steady pressures goes away, and that's what we call as brake fade, which means you're riding along, you're riding quite hard, and as you use your brakes again and again, you'll start finding that the lever actually comes back closer and closer to the bar, which means you have to use more of the lever, push the piston inside the master cylinder bigger distances to generate the same pressure that you were able to do before. That's called brake fade. Now, when most people suffer issues with their brakes, they're immediately starting to think about things like, I need to get my calipers cleaned, which might be a genuine problem. They think about getting better pad materials, and that might be one way to approach a solution. Or they might think about replacing the master cylinder with something with a smaller piston so that the multiplication factor in the hydraulic system is bigger, and therefore you can generate more force with the same lever effort. But what's usually wrong with the motorcycle or the car at that point is simply that their brake fluid is just old, and that means it had time to take on water, it's boiled a few times, there are impurities in the mix now, and therefore it's just not able to do its job. So for most people who ride seriously and drive seriously, we recommend that you should be changing your brake fluids once every year. That's how you keep the brake fluid topped up, you know that the levels are good and the fluid is good, which means it will do its job well. There's also something called DOT-5 brake fluids, which is a completely different chemical compositions. And for the purposes of this video, we're going to completely ignore DOT-5 because systems that run DOT-4 can't run DOT-5 because DOT-5 is more corrosive and it'll eat some of the seals and rubber in there and it'll cause an overall degradation of the braking system. So whatever you do, if you've got a vehicle with DOT-4 brake fluid in it, don't put DOT-5. What you should think about is putting something called DOT-5.1, which I'm going to call 5.1 for the rest of this video. The big change from 4 to 5.1 is simply a much bigger increase in the boiling point, which means you can use the brake more, allow more heat to build up in the system, and the fluid still doesn't boil, which means the brake performance stays more consistent. The fun part is that if you were to go on Amazon today and look for big brands like Brembo or Liqui Moly or any of these guys, you will find that 5.1 brake fluid bottles actually don't cost much. They're about $500 to $600 at the very maximum. And the brake force increase that you can get from this, the reliability of the system that increases with a small change like this, is so massive. It beggars belief for me that most people won't just take their DOT-4, throw it out of the window almost when the vehicle is new, and straight away go to 5.1. It's that much of an upgrade. The one option to that, which is still marked as DOT-4, is URBF, which is made by Putoline. They call it the Ultimate Racing Brake Fluid, which also has a much higher boiling point, although it's officially classified as a DOT-4 fluid. So in short, if you're having trouble with your brakes, instead of going for the expensive components first, which is things like replacing the master cylinder, getting braided lines, changing the pad materials, getting the calipers cleaned and all of that, and all of these are good solutions, I would say look at the fluid first. If the fluid levels are low or the fluid is old, chances are the problem has come from there and not from the rest of the hardware in the system. And if you are going to replace brake fluid, and you should do it once a year, like I said, think about getting 5.1. It's not an expensive upgrade, but it is a massive, massive upgrade, and I promise you, you'll be super happy with it. So happy that all the motorcycles I own have always run on 5.1 as soon as I've been able to change it, and every year they get fresh 5.1 and some of the best brakes I've ever experienced are on my motorcycles, and it's just the fluid. It has nothing to do with the hardware componentry that's in play. Thank you so much for watching. This is Simplified on Pardrift, where we take complicated ideas and break this down. If you have other ideas that can improve the braking experience with your vehicle, do leave us a comment. If there are other topics that Simplified should be attacking, do leave us a comment as well. Thank you so much for watching. If you find this useful, please do share it with your friends. And if you haven't, subscribe and hit the bell notification icon so that India's best automotive content is waiting for you in your inbox.